A very good morning, students. Welcome back to Social Science Online class. Students, today we are going to start chapter 14, the globe, latitudes and longitudes. We have studied in 6th class about the globe and latitudes lines and longitudes line. But today we will study these lines in detail. Now, the earth. As you all know that the earth is in spherical in shape and it is slightly flattened at the poles, lugging at the equator. Okay, now it is a third planet from the sun and it has its own natural satellite, that is the moon. It is also a fifth largest planet in the solar system. It is a unique planet because life exists here. Here we can find different types of gases, nitrogen, oxygen, argon, carbon dioxide, etc. It has liquid and frozen water also. The earth's shape is also described as geoid, which means earth shaped. Any object with this shape is called geoid. Now we come to the globe. A globe is a model of the earth. Okay, and it is slightly tilted just like the earth. Our globe, yeah, when you will see the globe, you will notice that it is mounted on a stand with its axis tilted by 23 1/2 degree from the vertical. And this is because our earth is actually tilted in this way. It is not possible to see all places in detail on a globe. Okay, so we need to rotate the globe to see the all parts of the earth. On globe, there are imaginary lines on which the earth rotates. The northern end of its axis is the north pole. You can see here in this diagram. And the southern end, the south pole. The earth rotates on its axis from west to east. These lines help us to find out our, you can say that to find our locations. These lines help us. There are horizontal and vertical lines on the surface of the globe and these lines are known as lines of latitude and lines of longitude. Horizontal lines are from east to west lines and they are called lines of latitude. Vertical lines are from north to south lines and they are called the lines of longitude. Lines of latitude and longitude form a network of lines that is called a grid. Okay, and together, this line help us to locate places on the map accurately. Now, lines of latitude. As you see in this diagram, these are the parallel lines. Okay. These are the parallel lines. You can see North Pole, South Pole, Equator. In the, it is degree also mentions. Now, I will tell you some facts about the lines of latitude. Latitude is an angular distance between the equator and any point north or south of it on the surface of the earth. They are also known as parallels and they run in an east-west direction. It can be measured distance north or south from the equator. If we want to measure the lines of latitude, then we have to measure from the equator. As you can see in the diagram, equator is mentioned 0 degree. Then when you are going on north, then you can see 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree and 40 degree onwards. Same when we are going towards south, it is 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree, 40 degree and 50 degree. It comes from the 90 degree. You can see in the diagram 90 degree is north pole and same way 90 degree is the south pole also. Okay, they are parallel to one another and never meet. These are the parallel lines as you can see in the diagram and they are never meet, but they never meet to each other, these lines. They cross the prime meridian at the right angle. Lie in the planes that cross the earth's axis at the right angles. They get shorter towards the poles. When you are seeing the north pole and the south pole, you are seeing that on the equator these lines are bigger. But as they are going to the north pole, they are coming to shorter and shorter. अच्छा आप लैटिट्यूड्स लाइन को देख रहे हैं, इसे पैरेलल लाइंस कहते हैं. ये ईस्ट टू वेस्ट डायरेक्शन में मूव करती हैं और ये इक्वेटर से, जब भी हम इसको अगर हमें कोई काउंटिंग देखनी है तो अब हम इक्वेटर से इसको काउंट करें, जैसे इक्वेटर से 0 डिग्री 10 डिग्री नॉर्थ की तरफ जाएंगे तो, और साउथ की तरफ जाएंगे इन सेम वे तो 0 डिग्री 10 डिग्री 20 डिग्री ये ऐसे इस तरीके से चलेगी। और यहाँ पर जितनी भी लाइंस ऑफ लैटिट्यूड है ये सारी पैरल्स है टू द इक्वेटर, ये इक्वेटर से पैरल है इसीलिए इसको पैरल्स कहा जाता है। और दीज ये जो लाइंस होती आर फुल सर्कल्स ओके बीच बिकम स्मॉलर, वो जो स्मॉलर मूव होती है जैसे जैसे वो पोल्स के पास जाएगी एज इट गोज टू द नियरर टू द पोल्स ओके। एंड सबसे लॉन्गेस्ट जो सर्कल होगा वो कौन सा होगा, इक्वेटर का ओके। इन डायग्राम ऑल्सो यू कैन सी डेट इक्वेटर इज अ लॉन्गेस्ट ग्रेट सर्कल। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज हीट जोन्स, एज वी मूव अवे फ्रॉम द इक्वेटर टूवर्ड्स द प्लोट्स पोल्स द क्लाइमेट चेंजेस ओके फ्रॉम हॉट टू वार्म, वार्म टू कूल एंड कूल टू कोल्ड इन बोथ हेमिस्फीयर एंड दिस इज ड्यू टू द रेज ऑफ द सन विच बिकम इंक्रीजिंग स्लाइंटिंग एंड देयरफॉर हीटिंग बिकम लेस। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द इक्वेटर द अर्थ इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री हीट जोन्स ओके। फर्स्ट इज टॉरिड जोन, इन द मिडल यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज टॉरिड जोन ओके। दिस इज अ टॉरिड मीन्स हॉट एंड इट लाइज बिटवीन द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर एंड नियर डाउन इट इज ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन, इट इज ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर एंड ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन एंड द सन रेज फॉल्स डायरेक्ट ईयर सो दिस इट इज अ हॉटेस्ट जोन। यहाँ पर सूरज की किरणें सीधी गिरती है इसलिए ये सबसे हॉटेस्ट जोन कहलाता है ओके। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज टेम्परेट जोन, इट कैन बी नॉर्थ टेम्परेट जोन एंड टेम्परेट जोन इट इज कैन बी साउथ टेम्परेट जोन ओके। दिस जोन्स लाइज बिटवीन द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर एंड द आर्कटिक सर्कल एंड डाउन इट लाइज इन द दिस ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर एंड द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन एंड द अंटार्कटिक सर्कल ओके। Here you can see that it is traditionally 1.5 degree to 66.5 degree north and 23.5 degree south to 66.5 degree south. Here the sun rays are slanting so the temperature is moderate temperature. Here is a moderate temperature. यहाँ पर सूरज की किरणें स्लैंडिंग मतलब कम गिरती हैं, जितना टॉरिड जोन में रेज एकदम डायरेक्ट गिरती है उतना नहीं होती है यहाँ पर रेज, इसी वजह से यहाँ पर मॉडरेट टेम्परेचर, ना ज़्यादा ठंड ना ज़्यादा गर्मी ओके। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज फ्रीजर जोन, इन फ्रीजर जोन इट मीन्स कोल्ड एंड इट द नॉर्थ फ्रीजर जोन एंड द साउथ फ्रीजर जोन ओके। हियर द सन रेज आर स्लैंटिंग एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज वेरी हीटिंग इन दिस जोन्स, ये इक्वेटर से भी दूर होने की वजह से यहाँ पर हीटिंग हीट्स कम होती हैं और हीट कम होने की वजह से यहाँ पर क्या रहती है, इट इज़ अ कोल्डेस्ट जोन, यहाँ पर ठंड रहती है ओके। So, the rays and the equator, it effect on the this year, the climate is affected. Now we come to the lines of longitudes or meridian. It is also known as meridians. Longitude is the angular distance of a point on the surface of the earth, which is measured in degrees east or west from prime meridian. Okay, there are some important points about this meridians. Lines of longitudes are known as meridians, means it means that midday, the midday is a halfway point of the sun's journey between sunrise and sunset. They run in north or north to south direction okay, and it is measured distance east or west of the prime meridian. They are farthest apart from the equator and meet at the poles. As we studied in the lines of latitude that cross the equator at the right angles. Now, the prime meridian 0 degree longitude passes through the British Royal Observatory at Greenwich near London. And opposite this meridian is a longitude of 180 degree. Together, these two lines divide the globe into two parts, the eastern hemisphere and the southern and the western hemisphere. These lines are equal in length, okay, and they have some great circles. Each line of longitude and its corresponding meridian are on the opposite side of the earth, which is 180 degree apart from the great circle. So the total lines will be 360 degree. Okay, there are 360 degree longitudes lines and 180 degree lines of latitude are there. Now next is longitude and time. Longitude help us to determine the time at a place. As you know that earth rotates from west to east or in an anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, what will happen? All places to the east of a particular meridian will have sunrise earlier and all places in the west will have it later. It takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Okay, and one rotation of earth takes 360 degree longitude. This means that the earth spins 15 degree in 1 hour or 1 degree in 4 minutes. Therefore, we can say that a place 1 degree east of another place will have sunrise 4 minutes earlier. Thus, each longitude has its own time, which is called the local time of the longitude. Okay, now, geographers, what they have done? They have divided our entire globe into 24 time zones, each with its own time. So, the difference between each time zone is 15 degree or 1 hour. Now, there are some definitions which you should know. First is local time, which I explained you that local time is, it is a time at a particular meridian calculated from the time at a prime meridian. IST, it is an Indian standard time. It is a time followed by the entire country, which is based on the local time of the central or standard meridian of India. Okay? And this all help it. It means that time difference of a place located 1 degree longitude apart will be 4 minutes. And this is very useful in calculating local time also. GMT, it is Greenwich time, mean time. It is local time at the prime meridian. Okay? Now, today we have studied lines of latitude and lines of longitude. You all know that lines of latitude are the parallel lines and lines of longitude are the meridian lines. And these lines help us to locate our places in our earth, to find out the globe. It is helpful in finding out our places. So, you should understand the lines of latitude and difference of the lines of longitude also. They help us to understand each and everything on our earth, which we can understand through our globe. So, the local time is determined by the longitudinal position of a place with respect to the prime meridian. And places on different longitudes will have a different local time also. So, if you have, students, read this chapter and watch the video carefully. If you have any problem, then same, you can call me or WhatsApp me that topic. Okay? Thank you, students.